Up on your feet together with me. Kita sama-sama berdiri.
Joy, Alleluia, Alleluia. More than anything.
kepada Tuhan. Yes, Anda bisa dipersilakan dulu kembali, Bapak Ibu ini di sini. See the power of God being poured out in this place. Kami mau melihat kuasa Tuhan dinyatakan di tempat ini. Minggu kemarin Bapak Ibu ketika kita bergandengan tangan, ada seorang ibu di tempat ini yang shoulder-nya sakit pada waktu itu. Ketika dibergandeng tangan oleh hadirat Tuhan, ibu itu disembuhkan Tuhan. Dan saya percaya dan trust that today God is doing the same thing. He will show and perform and display His mighty work in this place. Holy Spirit, we invite you. Touch every single person in this place, especially those who are Father. We ask your blessing, my Lord. Pour this piece of blessing and grace be poured out upon us, my Lord. And today we want to hear the word of God speak to us. Bicara kepada kami, Tuhan. Biar firman mengubahkan kami. Firman boleh merestorasi hidup kami. Di dalam nama Yesus kami berdoa. Dan melepaskan berkat. Yang percaya bilang, amin. Berikan sorak sekali lagi bagi Tuhan kita. Haleluya. Berikan selamat kita.
Father's Day.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Ya, keluar dari tempatnya, salamin yang dilihat bapak-bapak di situ, disalamin, bilang Happy Father's Day.
Get up from the where you sit, and if you sit that, can you please wish them Happy Father's Day.
Happy Father's Day.
Happy Father's Day.
Say again, Happy Father's Day.
Happy Father's Day.
Kurang meriah, kurang meriah, bilang lagi.
Happy
Father's
Day.
Berapa banyak yang bisa menikmati pujian dalam hadirat Tuhan tadi?
How many of you experience the praise and worship that we just had?
Anak-anak tidak usah keluar di sini saja karena ada yang menerjemahkan.
Children, you don't need to go out there to Sunday school because we have translation here.
Bilang gini, Tuhan itu baik ya.
Let's say God is good.
Kurangnya.
Not enough.
Bilang, God is good.
Let's say Tuhan itu baik.
Ya, gitu dong.
Yes, like that.
Hari ini saya dipelonco sama anak-anak.
Today I've been bullied by my children. Bullied or spoiled?
Disuruh memen pujian, disuruh khutbah.
I was asked to lead the worship. I was asked to preach.
Disuruh masak tapi tidak sempat.
I also have been asked to cook, but I didn't have enough time.
Diwakilkan yang lain saja.
So you represented by other people to cook.
Bilangan pasal 14 ayat yang ketiga.
Okay, let's open our Bible in Numbers 14 verse 30.
Pastor Eli reading in English.
30. Thank you. I'm going to read it in English. Not one of you will enter the land I swore with uplifted hand to make you home.
Bilangan 14:30.
Yeah, the Numbers 14 verse 30.
Kita akan lihat sama-sama dan kita akan baca bareng-bareng dalam bahasa Indonesia. Yang berbahasa Inggris bilang siap.
Yeah.
Kurang. Siap. Yeah. Tapi datanya puan. Siap. Oke, baca sama-sama ya, 2, 3. Bahwasanya kamu ini tidak akan masuk ke negeri yang dengan apa? Menangkap sumpah telah kujanjikan akan kuberikan kamu diami. Kecuali siapa? Caleb bin Yefun dan Yosua bin Nun. Bapak Ibu tahu gak bahwa ketika Tuhan bawa umatnya masuk negeri Kanan?
Brother and sister, ladies and gentlemen, do you know when God bring his people to enter the promised land, the Canaan?
Hanya Yosua dan Caleb dan generasi baru yang tiba masuk negeri Kanaan.
Only Joshua, Caleb and the new generation be able to enter the promised land, Canaan.
Yang lain gatot.
The rest failed.
Tahu gatot?
You want understand what gatot means or failed?
Gagal total.
Completely failed.
Jangan jadi gatot.
Don't become a completely failed person.
Bilang kiri kanan. Jangan jadi gatot.
Let's say to your neighbors, don't become a completely failed person.
Pemelan sebelah nih bilang, oh, kamu jangan gatot lo ya. Gitu.
Pat your neighbor and say, don't become a completely failed person.
Amin.
Amen.
Kenapa gagal?
Do you know why they failed?
Kenapa Yosua bisa masuk, Caleb masuk, generasi baru masuk, yang lain gagal?
Why Caleb, Joshua and the new generation able to enter the promised land, but the rest were failed? Why?
Saudara, Yosua, Caleb bisa masuk dari Kanaan karena punya satu spirit yang beda.
Do you know Joshua and Caleb able to enter the promised land because they had a different spirit?
Spirit of optimism.
They own spirit of optimism. Raw optimistic.
Optimist.
Raw optimist or the spirit of of optimism.
Saya senang tadi puji-puji mereka itu optimis banget.
I really love the worship. They were so optimistic.
Tadi mulai dancing semua ya.
The men were dancing like that.
Ya lalu.
Yes. They dance for the Lord.
Yeah. Dancing. Optimist.
They were optimistic. They dance for the Lord.
Jangan jadi orang gak optimis.
Do not be a non-optimistic person.
Kegagalan bukan berarti Anda gak bisa sukses.
Failure doesn't mean that you can't be success.
Kegagalan itu sukses yang tertunda aja.
Failure is the delayed success. Amen.
Harus optimis.
You have to be optimistic.
Yang percaya bilang amin.
If you believe, say amen.
Saya percaya Bapak Ibu.
I believe, brother and sister.
Kalau Abraham Lincoln.
If Abraham Lincoln.
Yang hidupnya sempat selama kurang lebih 29 tahunan. Kurang lebih sekitar itu.
Whose life for 29 years always experience failure, always.
Bayangin tahun 31 bankrupt.
Imagine in the year 1931 he was bankrupt.
Tahun 32 gagal dalam pemilihan lokal.
1932 he failed and he lost in the election.
Tahun 33 gagal lagi, bangkrut usahanya lagi.
In the year 1933 he also got bankrupt, his business failed or closed.
Tahun 35 istrinya wafat.
In the year 1935 his dad passed away.
Tahun 36 stres.
In the year 1936 he got depressed.
Tahun 37 gagal lagi.
In the year 1937 he also failed.
Gagal bangkrut lagi Bapak Ibu.
And also he got bankrupt again.
Tahun 40.
In the year 1940.
Coba ngelamar menjadi anggota senat di Amerika. Kalah lagi.
He tried to apply to become senate in America, parliament. And guess what? He failed again.
Tahun 42 nyoba untuk menjadi MP, gagal lagi.
In the year 1942, he tried to apply for become MP, but actually he failed again.
Tahun 48 nyoba MP lagi, gagal lagi.
In the year 1948, the same, he tried to apply to become MP, and guess what? He failed again.
Tahun 55 nyoba senat lagi, gagal lagi.
In the year 1955, he tried to become senator in American Parliament. He failed again.
Tahun 56 nyoba jadi wapres, gagal lagi.
In the year 1956, he tried to apply to become vice president and he failed again.
Tahun 58.
In the year 1958,
nyoba ngelamar senat lagi.
He tried again to become senate.
Gagal lagi.
He failed again.
Gagal, gagal, gagal. Gagal.
Failure.
Tapi satu dia
punya. But one thing he had.
Dia tetap optimistic.
Amen. He still was an optimistic person. He had optimism.
Dia terpercaya kalau Tuhan one day buka jalan, gak ada satupun yang bisa tutup jalan itu.
Amen. He believed that if God opened the door, no one can close that door.
Tahun 60.
The year 1960.
Dia dilantik menjadi presiden Amerika.
He was appointed to be American president.
Kalau saat ini ada yang duduk.
If you are now sitting down.
Pacaran gagal terus.
If you keep failing in your dating life.
Usaha gagal terus.
And your business keep getting bankrupt and fail.
Hari ini Tuhan mencari hati yang optimis.
And today God is looking for the optimistic heart.
Siapa yang mau menjadi orang yang optimis?
Who wants to be optimistic?
Angkat tangan yang tinggi dengan turun dulu.
Raise your hands please. Thank you.
Sehingga pulang Anda menjadi orang yang optimis.
You go home from this place, you become an optimistic person. Amen.
Siapa yang butuh jodoh?
Who wants partner?
Yang sudah sold jangan angkat tangan.
If you already married or sold, don't raise your hand please.
Yang masih single.
If you are single.
Lo gak mau ya?
You don't want it?
Tadi mau tak cariin jodoh lah.
I was going to look for you your partner.
Dan masalah ini banyak loh relatifnya.
Many partner is relative.
Tapi yang sudah menikah jangan angkat tangan, gak sok.
If you are married, never raise your hand. Don't raise your hand.
Mungkin jangan angkat tangan, Enggi. Enggi lah karena suka terpangkat tangan gini. Dicepet sebelahnya dulu.
Mr. Enggi, don't raise your hand. Careful.
Gak bisa pulang.
Because you can't go home later.
Nah, sekarang bagaimana kita membangun spirit of optimism here?
How do we build the spirit of optimism?
Yohanes pasal yang ke-6.
John 6.
Kita akan buka ayat 5 sampai ayat yang ke-7 lebih dulu. Yohanes pasal 6 ayat 5 sampai 7. Lebih dulu ini dulu ya, nanti kita akan lihat bagaimana kita membangun spirit optimism itu.
John 6:5.
Ya, Indonesia dulu ya.
Yep.
Siap yang Indonesia baca?
Let's read in Indo first.
Bilang, siap.
Ready.
Berubah dikit suaranya. Siap.
Siap.
Oke ya. 1, 2, 3. Ketika Yesus memandang sekelilingnya dan melihat bahwa orang banyak berbondong-bondong datang kepadanya, berkatalah ia kepada Filipus, di manakah kita akan membeli roti supaya mereka dapat makan? Ayat yang selanjutnya 6. Hal itu dikatakannya untuk mencobai dia, sebab ia sendiri tahu apa yang hendak dilakukannya. English, please.
Okay. Verse 5. When Jesus looked up and saw a great crowd coming toward him, he said to Philip, "Where shall we buy bread for these people to eat?" He asked this only to test him, for he already had in mind when he was going to do.
Anda bisa lihat ini di daerah Tiberias.
Imagine this is Tiberias area region.
5,000 orang datang.
5,000 men were there.
Saya pikir cuma laki-laki 5,000-nya itu.
I thought it's only men.
Belum perempuannya.
Not to to be counted the women, the ladies.
Belum anak-anak.
And also the children.
Kita mau kasih makan 5,000 orang itu dari mana?
How do we feed 5,000 men?
Bayangin dalam sekejap lah. Untuk mensuplai makanan 5,000 orang itu enggak gampang.
Imagine in the blink of eye you have to provide 5,000 food for 5,000 men.
Itu impossible.
That was impossible. Tidak mungkin.
Mungkin. Bilang tak mungkin.
Let's say with us. Impossible.
Betul? Enggak mungkin.
Impossible.
Tapi dikatakan di sini dia berkata gini, for he had already had in mind what he was going to do. Artinya dia belum tahu apa yang harus diperbuat. Ya, thank you. Jadi yang pertama,
so the first thing,
untuk memiliki spirit yang optimis,
to own an optimism spirit,
tidak bergantung resources.
It does not depend on the resources.
Yang setuju bilang amin.
If you agree, say amen.
Mungkin kita nggak punya apa-apa.
Maybe we don't, we have nothing.
Untuk meraih mimpi-mimpi kita.
To reach our dreams.
Tapi hari ini.
But today.
Tuhan cuma mencari orang-orang yang punya spirit of optimism.
God only looks for a person with optimism spirit.
Kita enggak bergantung resources.
We don't depend and rely on the resources.
Saya dulu waktu dapat jodoh itu bukan nyari-nyari kayak nyari ayam di hutan.
When I got my wife, I wasn't looking like a chicken.
Dia, ya?
Looking for food in the jungle.
Halo? Di mana dia ya?
Looking around.
Ke dapur cari ada jodoh di
sini.
Ikut sini Eli.
Looking for my partner. No, I did not do that.
Enggak perlu sama ibu, enggak perlu nanti cari-cari di bawah kolong.
It was not necessary for me to look under the chair.
Sebelah mana?
Oke,
Enggak perlu.
Not necessary.
Bilang, enggak perlu.
Let's say with me, do not necessary.
Kita enggak bergantung resources.
We are not depending on resources and rely on them.
Jodoh enggak dicari-cari.
Partner not for looking.
Adam dapat Hawa itu tidak perlu Adam nyariin di mana ya? Hawa. Tidak perlu.
When Adam got Eve, Adam didn't look for like and then say, Eve, where are you, Eve?
Tidak perlu.
Never, not necessary.
Tuhan sudah provide.
Because if God provides,
pasti dapat.
Amen. You will get.
Salam buat Tuhan kita. Bilang, oh, berkasnya.
God is great.
Apa ibu? Gak bergantung resources.
Brother and sister, never depends on the resources. We don't depend on the resources.
Ya, yang belum punya rumah, mimpin punya rumah.
Amen. If you still don't have home, own a home, please, you have a dream of owning homes.
Kalau sudah waktu yang tersedia, kan pasti dapat.
Because in God's time, you will get it in God's time.
Amen. Yang percaya bilang amen.
Amen.
Bapak ibu, saya percaya bahwa Tuhan mampu menyediakan.
God provides.
Josh Mueller adalah seorang contoh yang memiliki spirit of optimism.
Is an example a person who has a spirit of optimism.
Bayangkan dia enggak punya resources.
He didn't have any resources.
Tapi dia memelihara 10,000 anak yatim piatu.
But he actually took care of 10,000 orphanages children.
Enggak ada sumber dana.
He didn't have any resources.
Enggak ada backup.
He didn't have backup.
Tapi pelihara 10,000 anak kecil.
But he took care 10,000 little orphanages children.
Beberapa kali ketika waktu makan.
Many times when they were going to eat.
Mejanya kosong.
The table was empty.
Gak ada makanan.
Didn't have any food on it.
Tapi Josh Mueller punya spirit of optimism.
But Josh Mueller own spirit of optimism.
Anak-anak, yuk kita berdoa.
Children, shall we pray?
Dia doa sederhana, Bapak.
And he prayed a simple prayer. Father,
anak-anak butuh makan.
Your children need food.
Masa dimakan wheat?
And we going to feed them with wheat?
Nggak mungkin.
Impossible.
Saya percaya dia memuji Tuhan dalam doanya.
Then he worship God in his prayer.
Dan enggak berapa lama lagi orang ketok pintu. Tok 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 tok.
Not long after, someone actually knocked on the door.
Dia buka pintu.
And he opened the door.
Makanan tersedia di depan pintu.
The food are provided in front of the door.
Bilang Tuhan dahsyat. Tuhan dahsyat.
God is great.
Dan itu bukan kejadian sekarang nih, buat kami.
That's not happening only one time.
Itu balik-balik.
But it happening many, many times.
Kalau sekali kebetulan.
If it's only happen one time, it's called coincidence.
Karena tahu untuk bayar gedung gereja yang berhutang ini.
You know to pay for this mortgage of this building, the debt?
Bukan dikit, Bapak itu.
It's not a little amount.
Tapi nyatanya Tuhan selalu menyediakan dengan cara-cara.
Amen. But all of this time, God always provide with His wonderful way. Amen.
Kenapa?
Miraculous way. Why?
Karena saya percaya.
Because I believe.
Kalau dulu Tuhan utus saya ke sini.
If God sent me over here in the past.
Gak pakai support.
And without any support.
Tapi nyatanya Tuhan melihara.
And the fact is, God always provide and God always take care.
Tuhan itu bisa gerakan orang Indonesia tiba-tiba. Saya gak pernah minta, gak pernah ngomong, gak pernah online-an. Itu tiba-tiba tergerak ngirim duit masuk akun kita, Bapak Ibu.
I never ask for any help, but someone in Indonesia suddenly just send transfer money to help to pay for the building. I believe that was God.
Karena saya gak bergantung kepada resources.
Because Pastor Johan never depend on the resources.
5,000 orang enggak tahu cara makannya bagaimana, tapi dikatakan Tuhan tahu apa yang akan dia perbuat.
5,000 people, they don't know how, they didn't know how to feed them, but it says in the Bible, it already had in mind what he was going to do.
Yang percaya gini, mantap.
If you believe, you nod your head.
Rambutnya kurang, kayak ayam masa kalah sama ayam.
Nod your head like chicken.
Kalau ayam makan jagung kan begini, mantap.
When chicken eat corn, they say like.
Yang kedua.
The second one.
Bagaimana kita bangun spirit of optimism?
How do we build the spirit of optimism?
Ayat yang ketujuh, Pastor Eli, read in English, please.
Verse 7. Philip answered him, "It will take more than half a year's wages to buy enough bread for each one to have a bite."
Dikatakan dalam bahasa Indonesia, ayat 7. Coba Filipus kepadanya roti seharga 200 dinar. 200 dinar.
So it says Filipus say the bread cost 200 dinaris.
Tidak cukup untuk mereka ini. Sekalipun masing-masing dapat sepotong kecil aja.
It will not enough for everyone except if people one person just get a one small portion.
Ada bawa roti enggak?
Is there anyone here bring any bread?
Lupa bawa roti.
Do you bring any bread?
Bayangin roti ini ya, segini ya.
Yeah, imagine this big of bread.
Kalau yang ini,
for this, kecil, small.
Bisa.
Maybe
bisa.
It's enough, small lady.
Yang ini, dikit, boleh. Cuma dansanya jadi lemes.
For this man, maybe still enough.
Tapi ya, menunjuk sendiri.
Than the
10%
of course.
Kalau biasa makan sampai 2 piring, 3 piring, lah ini gak nendang.
If normally a person eat like 2 portions of plates or 3 portions, oh, if small portion is not enough.
Gak nendang.
Cannot kick. Cannot be kicked. Because it's too small portion.
Jadi boleh bilang orang-orang mulai tawar hati.
So it can be said that people surrounding start to get losing heart, lose their heart.
Jadi yang kedua supaya kita tetap punya spirit optimism.
So the second one, how to get a spirit of optimism?
Jangan tawar hati.
Never lose heart, amen.
Tawar hati itu artinya
the definition of lose heart is
kehilangan keberanian.
That you are discouraged.
Kehilangan bahagia.
You lost happiness. You lose happiness.
Tawar hati arti kehilangan gairah.
And the third meaning is disheartened.
Coba berdiri sebentar, berdiri.
Can we please stand up? Please stand up. Please stand up. Please stand up.
Kasih semangat kiri kanan. Kasih high five.
What? Give high five to
mantap,
your neighbor.
Yang mantap.
Give high five with passion.
Yeah.
Give high five.
Ini kalau mantap ya. Kalau mantap give me high five. Yang mantap.
Gawat.
Ini mantap.
This is very confident.
Nah, kalau tawar hati itu gini.
Lose heart is like this.
Hai. Tak gila. Hai.
That is what we call lose heart. Very weak. Very weak.
Anda tawar hati atau semangat?
So, do you have a, are you losing heart or are you have a compassion heart?
Passion tawar hati, Bapak Ibu.
Do not lose heart.
Ada orang bikin eksperimen.
So there was a person making experiment.
Dua tikus dimasukkan ke dalam apa namanya itu apa istilahnya? Tabung berisi air.
So this person did experiment putting two rats. Is that rat or mouse?
Yes, rat.
Rats. the person put the two rats into a container.
One rat.
Into a container.
Lampu dimatiin.
And then he turn switch off the light.
Anda tahu?
You know?
Butuh waktu 3 menit.
It takes only 3 minutes.
Itu tikus mati.
The rat died only 3 minutes.
Karena dia coba berusaha, gak kelihatan, gak ada harapan, tawar hati, 3 menit mati.
Because the rat was trying to get up from the container and because it was so dark he felt like he didn't have any hope. Then 3 minutes later, he died.
Tapi tikus yang kedua dimasukkan lagi tempat yang sama.
There was one more rat, a big rat, to be put in the container.
Lampunya dinyalakan.
And then the person opened the light.
Coba lagi keluar.
And the rat try to escape from the container.
Tahu ada berapa lama?
Do you know how many minutes?
36 jam.
36 hours the rat survived in the container.
No, that survive. Jadi 36 jam, walaupun mati tapi 36 jam lebih lama.
Yeah. Even though he lived for, he finally died, the rat died, but he could stand for 36 hours.
Kenapa? Karena dia tapi lupa.
Because the rat had optimistic spirit.
Saya kepengen Bapak Ibu pulang tempat ini.
I want you, when you go home from this place, I want you to have optimistic spirit.
Saya gak punya waktu lagi untuk kasih kesaksian tentang tawar hati, tapi saya loncat langsung bahan yang ketiga.
I don't have any time to give you another testimony. I will jump to the number 3.
Second. Ayat yang ke-9.
Okay. Verse 9.
Langsung saya baca Indonesia aja ya, atau English please.
Okay, thank you.
Tayangkan Indonesia tapi dibaca dalam bahasa Inggris.
Yeah. Here's a boy with 5 small barley loaves and 2 small fishes. But how far will they go among so many people?
Cuma punya 5 roti.
Only have 5 small barley loaves.
2 ekor ikan.
2 small fishes.
Dikatakan mana cukup?
It says how far will this go?
Jadi kalau Anda kepingin punya spirit optimist,
so if you want to own the spirit of optimistic of optimism,
miliki rasa cukup.
Yeah. Own the feeling of being enough, sufficient and content.
Orang yang pesimis itu biasanya kejar apa yang sudah dapat, mau dapat lagi. Itu gampang jatuh kepada spirit yang enggak optimis.
A pessimistic person always never feel enough. They want to get more and more and more, and they will end up with non-optimistic.
Makanya Tuhan ajar dalam doa Bapa kami, berikanlah pada hari ini makanan kami apa? Selimpah-limpahnya. Apa?
Secukupnya. Therefore, Jesus actually teach us the Lord's Prayer. Lord, give us daily bread. It means an enough daily bread.
Tujuan supaya Anda tetap optimis.
The reason is so you become an optimistic person.
Kalau sudah berkat kita nggak bisa hilang, Bapak Ibu, setuju? Yeah.
If it's your portion of blessing, it will not go anywhere.
Yang saya bilang amin.
If you agree, say amen.
Masih punya rasa cukup.
So you have to have the feeling of content and enough and sufficient.
Saya pernah dengar kesaksian.
I ever heard a testimony.
Seorang bapak namanya Sarimin.
A man called Sarimin.
Sarimin, bukan Sarimi, Sarimin.
It's not Sarimi, but Sarimin.
Sarimin itu aktif dalam pelayanan.
Sarimin was an active person in the ministry.
Dan dia ditugaskan gerejanya untuk mengurus orang mati.
And he was assigned by his church to deal with dead people or funeral.
Jadi kalau ada yang mati ngurusnya pasti manggil Sarimin.
So if there were dead people in the church, you go to Sarimin to find help.
Nah, satu kali Sarimin dapat lihat di mana di internet dia ada tawaran genset, 2 genset generator itu harganya murah. Mas second hand tapi baru dibeli setahun, masih baru grass, baru setahun, belum dipakai. Harganya murah, 2.
One time, this Sarimin person, the person named Sarimin, look at the news advertisement and he says a generator was sold for a very cheap price even though it's only been used for 1 year.
Sarimin nelpon, Pak, nanti saya beli, saya mau pergi, hari ini saya ambil.
And then Sarimin says to this person, sir, I'm going to buy the generator. I'm going to come and take it.
Baru bikin appointment.
Just making appointment with the person.
Teleponnya bunyi.
The phone ringing.
Pak Sarimin.
Mr. Sarimin.
Bumlam mati.
That person is die.
Namanya Bumlam.
Okay. Bumlam is die.
Tolong Bumlam dikuburkan.
Tolong. Please help to bury Bumlam.
Apa Sarimin bilang?
Do you know what Sarimin said?
Duh, Bumlam ya, mati aja kok ya cepet-cepet, tunggu 5 menit atau 1 jam lagi gitu lumayan, set ambil, baru mati.
Sarimin had his mind thinking that, why Bumlam you passed away now? Why don't you wait another 5 minutes so after I took the generator, I come and bury you?
Oh, gak sabar mati aja, gak sabar.
You don't be patient to just pass away.
Akhirnya habis ngubur?
After the funeral,
Daniel pun ke jenazahnya terus punya jenazah.
And he Sarimin called the person who sell the generator.
Dia bilang, sorry pak, jenazahnya laku.
And the person who sell the generator say, I'm sorry man, the generator already sold.
Sarimin sedih bapak ibu.
Sarimin was so sad. He was crying.
Sedih.
He was very sad.
Sayang.
Oh, what an unfortunate, what a shame, what a pity.
Gara-gara Bumlam keburu meninggal,
jenazahnya
hilang.
Because Bumlam passed away, the generator's gone.
Seharian murung, Bapak Ibu.
And the whole day he was very sad.
Sore-sore nonton TV.
In the afternoon when he watched television.
Lagi asyik-asyik nonton apa namanya itu.
While he was enjoying watching at the movies,
muncul news.
There was news come. Okay.
Ternyata.
Apparently.
Ada urusan dengan generator.
There was news regarding pertaining to generator.
Yang jual dan yang beli ditangkap polisi.
The one who sell the generator and the one who buy the generator was captured, was caught by the police.
Akhirnya dia tahu, oh itu genset yang mau saya beli.
Oh, that was the generator that I was going to buy.
Katanya si Sarimin bilang gini, untung ya Bumlam cepat-cepat mati.
Then Sarimin say, oh praise God that Bumlam passed away.
Untung matanya Bumlam berada atas, gue lempar sandal loh.
And maybe Bumlam will say, oh I'll kick you with the sandals.
Ingat.
Remember.
Anda harus punya spirit cukup.
You have to have the spirit of being enough, feel enough, and sufficient.
Kalau itu berkat kita, pasti ke kita. Kalau bukan, ya nggak apa-apa, direlain aja.
If the blessing belongs to us, it will come to us and it will go. God will provide better than that. Amen.
Yang pasti Tuhan mencukupkan segala yang kita butuhkan. Bisa orang bagi Tuhan kita. Tampilkan Indonesianya, Inggrisnya dibaca, ayat 11.
Verse 11. Jesus then took the loaves and after giving thanks, he distributed to them to those who were reclining. Likewise also of the fish, as much as they wanted.
Tahu nggak Bapak Ibu, bisa mengucap syukur itu adalah tanda Anda antusias.
Do you know giving thanks, it is a sign of you are an enthusiastic person.
Lihat, orang yang ngomel-ngomel sama orang yang kasih thanksgiving itu beda.
Look, if you pay attention, people who always complain and people who always giving thanks, they are two different person.
Anda pulang depan jangan lagi kalian antusiasme.
You go home from this place, I don't want you to lose your enthusiastic spirit.
Orang yang punya spirit optimis itu pasti dia antusias.
The people who own optimism spirit, that person should have an enthusiasm spirit.
Cuma punya 5 roti 2 ekor ikan tapi itu berkata, aku mengucap syukur, ini pasti ada mujizat.
Even though you only have 5 small breads and 2 small fishes, we believe that God will provide.
Yang percaya bilang amin.
You believe, say amen.
Saya enggak sempat kasih kesaksian tentang ini.
I don't have time to give another testimony about this.
Tapi percayalah.
But believe.
Kalau Anda antusias dalam Tuhan.
If you are enthusiastic in God,
Tuhan mencukupkan segala yang kita butuhkan.
Amen. God will provide all your needs.
Yang percaya bilang amin. Yuk kita berdiri sama-sama.
Let's stand up together.
sampai tak pemusik memuji naik lagi.
Yeah, praise and worship team to come.
Yeah, sama-sama yeah. Bisa naik ke atas. Tunjukkan bahwa kita adalah orang-orang yang punya optimisme.
Amen. Let's show that we are an optimistic person.
Berapa banyak yang mau menunjukkan bahwa saya punya optimisme? Katanya tinggi-tinggi.
How many of you want to say I want to to have optimistic spirit?
Sebelum saya serahkan kepada MC, saya kepengen katanya sekali lagi pujian ini ya. Baru saya serahkan kepada MC. Shout to the Lord. Kita berikan tepuk tangan buat dan kita lebih dulu.
Right now we are going to start our special program with a love letter from our Heavenly Father.
kasih semuanya atas penampilan yang sudah diperformkan. Sungguh berarti drama yang sudah ditampilkan tadi. Begitu menunjukkan kasih Tuhan kita untuk kita semua.
Thank you for all the meaningful drama of our Heavenly Father and His love for all of us.
Saya ingin mengingatkan sekali lagi untuk minggu depan tetap ada ibadah di tempat ini pukul 11 pagi. Dan kita akan dilayani oleh Pastor Dean dan Pastor Ellie. Kita percaya minggu depan kita akan diberkati lebih banyak lagi. Lalu selanjutnya kita akan mengundang saudara untuk dipersembahan. Sementara itu Sharon, Jeffrey, and Daniel akan mempersembahkan sebuah lagu buat kita semua.
We would like to give an opportunity for you to give while Sharon, Jeff, and Daniel present us a special song. Round of applause, please.
Thank you.
Sharon for that beautiful song.
Terima kasih sekali lagi atas semuanya, sangat memberkati kita. Sebentar lagi kita akan menutup acara pada hari ini. Namun sebelum itu, kami mengundang para bapak untuk maju ke depan. Sebentar lagi Pastor Neka akan mendoakan kita. Dimohon para bapak dan para pria bisa maju ke depan.
Thank you once again for celebrating Father's Day with us here. We will conclude the event for today, but before that, can we invite every man that is in this room to come forward, and we would like to honor you and bless you with Pastor Mikey. Can you please lead us in this prayer for this man?
Okay, all the men, so make sure you will stand up at the front. We're going to pray for you. All the men.
Are you ready? Mari kita berdoa.
Let's pray.
Tuhan Yesus.
Lord Jesus.
Kami bersyukur.
We want to give thanks to you.
Hari yang istimewa ini.
Today is a special day.
Tuhan panggil semua bapak-bapak.
You call all the men here.
Untuk dibangkitkan.
To be raised by you.
Dalam rohnya.
The spirit of God,
sehingga tetap optimis,
so that we, all of us, we gotta be optimists in facing any challenge in life.
Kami berkati semuanya, Tuhan.
We bless all of these men,
baik yang hadir tempat ini,
today this place or whatever they are,
yang ikut online karena berhalangan.
We join them online as well.
Dalam nama Yesus,
in the name of Jesus,
biar kiranya berkat yang istimewa,
that special blessing,
khusus untuk bapak-bapak dan calon bapak,
for all the men and also the would-be husbands in the future,
semua diberikan hikmat,
they will be given a special wisdom,
takut akan Allah,
the spirit of the fear of the Lord,
menjalani pimpinan Roh Kudus,
to always in the lead of the
Spirit
of God,
melaksanakan tugasnya dengan sukses,
to carry out all their tasks successfully,
melengkapi semua anggota keluarganya.
And equip all these men to be a blessing for their families.
Untuk masuk dalam keluarga ilahi rencana
Allah. To build help a godly families.
Terima kasih Tuhan.
Thank you Lord.
Berkati usaha pekerjaannya.
Bless all their careers.
Berkati masa depannya.
Bless their future.
Kami mohonkan semuanya.
I ask in the name of Jesus.
Dalam nama Yesus.
Everybody say amen.
Sebelumnya para bapak dimohon jangan kembali ke tempat duduk, bisa tetap berdiri. Kita akan mengambil foto sebentar.
Okay, all the men, just make sure you still stay in the front. And after. Photo taken.
Yeah, you can come in front.
Bisa jadi dua baris supaya bisa masuk semua dalam foto.
You got a hand of fries.
Thank you.
Oh, Brian, yes!
give that songs for you.
There are two sizes of the socks. You can choose whatever you fit for you. So all the men, just pick up your sock here. Come step up. Come on, all the men, just Danny. Who else? Alan, you got it? Okay, just who else?
Kate.
Harry, have you got it? Husband is not here, you can pick up for your husband as well. Linda, you can pick up for your for men. Yang suami gak di sini bisa diambilin bawa pulang. Yang suami gak di sini bisa dibawa pulang. Pilih size yang cocok. To the end of this service. So on this special day, I also want to invite Christopher Hess to come up here. Today is a special day. It's his birthday, actually. I think it would be good if you want to offer one song, Chris. Say one song. Yeah. Hello. Thank you.
And want me to sing a song? He must be in terrible problems.
Don't worry, no glasses here.
Hello, Mary Lou. Goodbye, heart. Sweet Mary Lou, I'm sorry. Pass me by one sunny day. Castle be brown.
Special day, and today we also want to pray for Chris. Today is special day, his birthday. I thank you as you has done great thing in his life, and today it is, I believe, that you keep doing great thing in his life. Keep long life, happiness, joyfulness, healthy body will be given fully to Chris. I bless Chris in the name of our Father and the grace of Jesus Christ and the peace of the Holy Spirit be with Chris forever in the name of Jesus. And now today, before we leave this place, my Lord, please pour out your special blessing. your grace and abundant love will be poured upon us, Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Every believer say, Amen. Amen. Happy Father's Day. Let's go. Happy birthday.
Welcome to our last and the other room.